We see from the life of Tariq bin Ziyad, the tawakkal in Allah. And we see from the life of different companions, the way when they accepted Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave them hope. Yusuf alayhi salam was the prophet of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him go to the well, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made him a minister at one time. This is the hope. Yunus alayhi salam, caught in the belly of the fish, lived there for a very long time. Darkness of sea, darkness of the belly of the whale. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took him out of that, and he was given another life of freedom. This is the hope a Muslim has when he starts believing in one God. This is the hope that a Muslim feels he can change himself. Same is the scenario with all the people. When Islam gave a civilization to all of us in a way that we can look upon too. This is the Islamic civilization which we got. And this only happens when we believe in Allah. When we know His attributes, you don't need to go and ask people. We don't need to beg people. Now the Caliphate, today's Prime Minister, First Lady, they don't do anything. But it was Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه who once saw children crying. And he went over there and he asked, what's the matter? The lady said that, you know, Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه is not a good caliph. He asked, what is the reason? So she said that he wanted to become a caliph, but he doesn't care about the people under him. I don't have anything to eat, and the children are crying. And it was the same person she was talking to, the caliph, Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه himself. He went to the Baitul Mal and he said that let me get something from them to eat. His slave said that let me carry. He said, no, on the day of judgment, you are not going to carry my sins. Let me do this. This was Umar رضي الله تعالى عنه. He gave the stuff to that lady and then he waited for them to be happy again. The Caliphate of Ali رضي الله تعالى عنه, Ali would also at night go in the different streets and see the problems of the people. This was because he was knowing that he has to be accountable. In atheism, there's no accountability, because accountability makes a person do something. So this was his taqwa, that he saw a traveler, that was a new person coming in with his wife, and his wife had to give birth to a child. This traveler said that, you know, I need a help. Ali رضي الله تعالى عنه said, let me go home and call my wife. He went home, he called his wife, and he said that this is an opportunity of doing good. Do you want us to do good? She said, yes, why not? So both of them came to this couple, husband and wife, and then the wife helped his wife. Both the guys collected some fire to do the stuff, to make food for them. And there was a born baby after some time. Early in the morning, he said that I want to meet the caliph of this place. You know, such nice people, they help one another. And it is discovered that he himself was a caliph. And when different people, the different kings would go and spy, you know, spies are everywhere. They would send their spies to the Muslim lands to see the behavior of Muslims. And they said that, wallahi, these people are from heavens. How are they from heavens? That at daytime they fight like warriors, but at night they worship like priests. So this was the state of the Ummah when they really believed in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they really knew about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they were really fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.